So, as you all know, I recently bought the cheapest Bentley in the world, a 1994 Brooklands by the name of Ron. I've given you the buying process, I've given you a full review, and so far, it's been bulletproof. But there's always been that niggling doubt in the back of my mind that below this sparkling purple exterior, it's a ticking time bomb. And that's why I've come to Bentley in Crewe, specifically their workshop, to figure out what's really wrong with Ron. Here is everything wrong with our Brooklands. So here I am with the man, the legend, Keith Downey. He's the heritage technician here at Bentley Motors. Keith, nice to meet you.
And you?
I'm a bit nervous today because I brought Ron along. This is my 1994 Brooklands, and I think it's brilliant, but obviously you're the expert. And I want you to talk me through basically everything that's wrong with this car.
Right. Be kind.
We haven't got that long. First impressions though, what do you think of it?
Seen better days outside, isn't it?
I mean, it's a bit sort of, it needs a bit of a tidy up on the outside.
Yeah.
But I happen to think that underneath is perfectly sound. It's just all the cosmetic stuff that's the issue. So maybe, should we start with the exterior, have a look around and see?
So, I mean, you drove it here, so it can't be too bad.
Yeah, I drove it about 3 hours here, actually, so it's sound. So, front end wise, what do you reckon?
Well, it's all there. I'll say all the gapping seems okay on it. Side air dam, out of line a little bit, but that's probably not a major issue.
Is that from someone just sort of crashing into something?
I'd imagine so. It's probably just got a curb.
Okay. If you make a list of everything that's wrong with it, we'll try and figure out how much that repair might cost. And then at the end, we'll know exactly what the repair bill was, as it were, so we can figure out how much in the hole we are with this car.
Right. Okay.
But front end wise, just the air dam at the front.
So the headlamp's got corrosion in it.
Where?
On the bottom there.
Oh yeah, okay. Is that bad? Just needs a new headlamp, right?
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Nothing too disastrous.
Okay. New air dam or just repositioned?
Repositioned, I'd imagine.
Okay.
Yeah. Right, turn the headlights on. Indicator.
Indicator.
We'll just check the back while we're at it.
I'll check the back ones. Yeah, all good. Don't worry about them.
Okay.
I can't actually turn off the wiper, it won't stop. We could just kill the engine. That's always a surefire way.
Yeah.
See, we're worried about things that don't work, so I'm going to ignore the fact that the wipers do work.
Your ignition theory didn't work. Yeah.
All right. So it needs a new ignition.
I'll just tap the end of the wash again. Just give it a bit of a strike.
Hit it?
Yeah.
So. I'm hitting it. Oh, look, it stopped. Hitting it works.
So that probably indicates,
good.
It's probably the wash wipe stalk.
Okay. New wiper stalk.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's the
They're not expensive, are they? It's for a Bentley, it will be. So down here on the center cap there.
Oh yeah.
On the alloy, that's really loose. Mm-hmm. So as I drive along, that's always vibrating constantly.
Yeah.
So
there should be a big O-ring.
Okay.
That's probably missing.
Right. I haven't got the key for that.
Oh right.
Screwdriver?
Drill.
Drill, got drill. It. Alright, cool. Add a drill to the shopping list. So obviously the trim down there is falling off, and there's a bit of corrosion there. Mm-hmm. Is that, how would you normally repair rust like that? Is it a case of cutting it out or doing a home repair?
I'd imagine cut it out, yeah.
Okay, all right, so, okay.
Yeah, because there's nothing to retain the clips anymore. This, you can see it's
okay, well, don't, just be gentle with it, all right, it's not yours.
I'm pushing it back in.
All right, bit more corrosion here, mm-hmm. but again, quite minor for a car that's like, built in 1994.
Yeah. Yes, reasonably bad.
Reasonably bad, but not like catastrophic. He's pulling chunks out of it. Rest of the wheel arch.
Yeah, it's pretty poor condition. When you put your fingers in there, that's full of mud.
But that's fine, a bit of a power wash, that'll sort it out.
It'll get rid of the mud, yeah.
And the arch.
Yeah.
On the upper window up there, there's a little bit of almost like paint seeping into the...
Yeah, that's the heated rear screen element.
Ah, right, okay.
It's just corrosion on the elements.
So to get rid of that, you're looking at a whole new rear screen.
Yeah.
Probably the worst bit, I think, aesthetically anyway, is the rear bumper, which has started to sort of peel off a little bit.
It's had a bit of a hard life, hasn't it?
Yeah, clearly someone's not been that good a driver.
A bit of parking by ear.
Yeah.
You can get the rubbers.
Oh, right.
The actual bumper beam is probably sound.
Okay.
But so you can get the new end caps and the new rubbers.
Oh, right. It's just a bit of trim almost that you could get rid of and repair. Okay. Mm-hmm. If you were to score this, let's say out of 10, what would you give the kind of exterior bodywork out of 10?
Probably a 4.
4?
Yeah.
That's quite generous, actually. I was expecting a lot less than that.
Well, everything seems straight. I mean, it's just the corrosion, really.
Yeah. Okay. First impressions on the interior?
Yeah, it's had a bit of use, hasn't it?
It's well worn.
Yeah, well worn.
What would be your approach in fixing some of these sort of bigger gaps? Are you talking about a whole new seat here?
I'd imagine so.
Right, okay.
Or retrimmed at least.
Okay.
Yeah.
As I was saying earlier, though, literally everything in here kind of works. All the electrics are pretty much sound. But I'll let you be the judge.
Let's have a quick run through, shall we?
Yeah, have a little poke.
Okay. Right, so the seats and mirrors seem fine.
Even the cruise control works.
Right. Map lights work as well.
Be honest, have you ever seen a Brooklands that's in as good condition as this in terms of the electrics?
Oh, never.
Never. There you go. See? Ron's winning.
Should we try the AC?
It works. Yeah, go on then. Yeah, fire it up. Yeah. Takes a while to start.
Yeah.
There you go.
Off crank. Right, let's try the horns. This is your normal horn.
Yeah.
And then your air horns are there.
Right.
But that should be twin horns.
It
sounds like there's only one working.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, got you. Oh, right, yeah. Okay. We'll add that to the list. How many horns does a car need?
On these lots.
Hear how smooth that is. Silky.
Yeah, it doesn't sound too bad, actually, does it?
Yeah. It does get cold.
Yeah, that's the warmth.
Oh, really?
That's the...
It was, honestly, it was working before you got in.
It's working.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, that's okay. That's not too bad.
Heating works. Yeah. Aircon works. Defrost.
Yeah, that all seems okay.
Works.
Yeah.
I shouldn't be pointing out these flaws, but there is one error message that I always get in this, which is mineral oil low.
Mm-hmm.
What's that to do with?
That's the brake fluid.
Oh, right, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But also for the levelling.
Okay, right. It doesn't. That explains a lot because the brakes are terrible.
Right. Okay.
Happy?
Yep. Should we move on?
Okay. Let's get you to score it again in terms of like the interior. Forget the electrics for a bit. Just the state of the interior. What would you rate that out of 10?
Probably a 6, something like that.
6, 7,
yeah,
8.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And the electrics?
They all seem pretty good.
So 10 out of 10.
At the moment, yeah.
Okay. Good. All right. What's next? What should you do next? I'm excited now.
Right. Do you want to go through the back?
Yeah, all right, cool. Jump to the back. He's looking impressed. What do you reckon?
Yeah, everything seems okay in the back here.
Score out of 10?
So it's probably looking sort of 7.
7? Yeah. Oh, come on. This is the best bit of the car. It's right. Even got the footrests.
Let's give it an 8.
8, yes. All right, we'll take that. What's the first thing you look for when you go under a bonnet?
Just cleaning this, really.
I think you'll be
initially
impressed by this.
It doesn't look that bad, actually.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm. It all seems actually quite dry.
No leaks.
And the other thing to check on these is the front chassis leg, the longeron.
Okay.
They're prone to having little bumps and they do bend, but this one seems fine. Reasonably dry, a little bit of weeping on that reservoir hose.
That's probably me filling up the engine oil and not doing it very well, just like spilling it.
No, that's been there for a while.
Okay. Yeah. See right through my excuse. Yeah.
Weeping on these hoses, they're the feed hoses for the brake pumps from the brake reservoirs. See here.
All right. Will they last much longer, do you reckon, or hard to say?
Is there a safety item I'd get them looked at sooner rather than later?
Okay. You're impressed, aren't you?
It's not bad, actually, yeah.
Right. The bit that I was genuinely concerned about is underneath, because mm-hmm. obviously you can't really see what sins lie underneath the car, which is why I'm glad we've got a ramp today. Mm-hmm. So, good logical next step, do you reckon?
Yeah, let's get it in the air.
Cool. All right. It does look fairly dry from where I'm standing. Ish.
Steering back's leaking. You got a bolt missing out the sump there.
Okay, yeah, that's just, okay.
That could be causing the leak.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think it's that bad, actually. It's like a clean off and an assess. That probably isn't actually the rack that's leaking, looking at it now, before he keeps coming down from further up.
Yeah.
On that sump. Rocker cover's dry, which is quite unusual. Engine mounts are split. Well, this one is anyway. You come and have a look at this engine mount. You see this line running up?
Yeah,
so that separated that engine mount.
Is that a problem?
Yeah, you could do it.
Is that exhaust all right?
Yeah, it's just out the cover.
Okay.
It's not blowing.
No.
A little bit concerned about this.
What's that?
The train arm. Okay. The corrosion on there, you can see there?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So this is where the spring sits.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So it could end up with the spring coming through.
Right.
So that's something wants a bit further investigation into.
Okay.
Again, that's probably just years of having mud and things set in there.
Yeah.
Was it a farmer that owned this before? So you've had, again, a bit of corrosion on this one. So they both need sort of looking at in a bit more depth.
Yeah.
This feel quite worn.
Yeah. I mean, the brakes barely work, so right. I'm not expecting there to be any discs, to be honest.
Yeah, there's quite a bit of wear on those rear discs.
Yeah. Okay. You look happy.
Right. You look happy. Yeah.
Take that. All right, so we're going to do it again. We'll rate it out of 10 for the underside and the general condition of Ron Burgundy. Out of 10, what would you give it?
Probably about an 8. So the train arms give it by a little bit. If it wasn't for the trailing arms.
So hang on. So the best bit of this car is underneath.
Yeah, we thought it'd be the worst.
That is a result.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. Yeah. Thank you, Keith.
No problem.
I don't know about you, but I am genuinely surprised by that.
Yeah,
I came here expecting the worst.
Yeah.
And it's actually, it's not in bad nick, is it?
No, underneath it's pretty good. Yeah.
The worst bit, definitely the bodywork, I'd say.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Any safety issues?
Just on those rear springs, I'd say, to those looked at.
So the trailing arm?
The train arm seats, yeah, okay. Spring seats.
Okay, but apart from that, nothing too mechanically worrying in terms of your expert eye?
It seems reasonable.
That's impressive. I thought you'd want to set it on fire and roll it off a cliff or something.
No, I mean, for a 28-year-old car.
Yeah. That's decent. Mm. Good. All right, so I think what we've just seen is that Ron is in really good nick, thank God. We'll fix a couple of things, not everything, but I think the next step is to basically bring it up to scratch in terms of the aesthetics, make it look amazing, maybe nick a few bits from around here. I see some wheels out there that I might chuck on, but apart from that, happy days. Stay tuned and let me know in the comments down below what you think we should do to Ron in terms of improving its aesthetic look. Cheers for watching, guys. Thank you, Keith.
No problem. Pleasure.
Appreciate that.
Thank you.
See you guys soon.